Sometimes what you need is all the facts just in one place. So that's why today on Math Hacks, I am running you through the 10 facts that you need to know to solve any linear equation problem. Linear equations can be described by three key pieces of information. Those are the x and y intercepts and the slope. The x-intercept is where our line crosses the x-axis. So with this line, it crosses the x-axis 1 unit to the left. So that's at -1. We would write that as the point -1, 0. Likewise, the y-intercept is where our line crosses the y or vertical axis. In our example here, we cross the y-axis 2 units up right here. So this point at +2, we would write that as the point 0, since we went left and right none, and 2 up. The third piece of information that's important to know is the slope, and we could count that by connecting any 2 points. Remember, slope is rise over run, so I'm simply going to go up, looks like 2 units for this problem, and in the positive x direction, 1 unit. So that is 2 up and 1 over. So our slope is +2 over +1, which equals 2. No matter how you count your slope, it will always reduce to the same number. And that number represents the rise over run. Slope is often described as the change in y over the change in x, or sometimes in a formula they write that as y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1, where the subscripts just indicate that there is one xy coordinate here and another xy coordinate used here. So no matter how we look at it though, the slope is always rise over run. So looking back at this first example, we found to go from this point that we went up 2 and over 1. That's how we got a slope of 2. We could also have counted from this point to this point. We would have gone down 2 and left 1. So that would be -2 over -1, which divides to +2 as well. We could also have used another point on this line, so perhaps this point, and we could have made a triangle between, say, this point and this point. In that scenario, we would have gone up 1, 2, 3, 4, and to the right, 2. That gives us a slope of 4/2, which again reduces to 2. So no matter how you're counting it off on the graph, slope is always going to reduce to the same number. And we could also just do this if we only have the coordinates. So say we had the point -1, 0, and 0, 2, and we want to calculate the slope from that. To do that, I'm going to take the difference in y's. Now it doesn't matter which point I use as the x1, y1, and x2, y2. I could use this as the first point or this one. I'm gonna go ahead and just use this as the first point and this as the second point. So y2 is 2 minus y1, which is 0, over x2 minus x1, which is -1. Do a little arithmetic here and we get 2 over 1, which is 2.
The easiest form of a linear equation to graph from is always going to be slope-intercept form, also known as y equals mx plus b.
Slope-intercept form is always the best form to graph from because they give you two key pieces of information. They give you the y-intercept, here represented by the letter b, and the slope, which is the coefficient on x, here represented as the letter m. So for example, if I want to graph the line y = -x + 2, all I have to do is take the y-intercept, so +2,
and mark it on my y-axis. And then take the slope, which is the coefficient. Here I just have a negative sign, so my coefficient is going to be -1. Now that is the slope, which, as we learned in the last step, was rise over run. So this, if I write it as a fraction, is -1/+1. All I have to do here is go to my point and apply that slope. So I'm gonna go down 1, right 1. And likewise, I could also go up 1 if I go -1 to the left.
To get any linear equation into slope-intercept form, all you need to do is solve for y.
Isolating for y will always get you into y=mx+b form, and y=mx+b form, remember, is the easiest way to graph it. So if you need to go from this equation to the graph, go ahead and solve for y first, and then once you have it in mx+b form, you can graph. So I started by adding 4x over. Now let's go ahead and add the 6 over. And lastly, make sure to divide everything by -2. Now it's in y=mx+b form. To graph this, I would mark -3 on my y-axis and then do a slope of down 2, right 1, or up 2, left 1 from that point.
Point slope formula is simply the slope formula in disguise.
To derive the point slope form of an equation from the slope formula, all you need to do is start by multiplying both sides by the denominator. So I'm going to multiply both sides by x^2 - x^1. On the right hand side, it's going to cancel out. So we have y2 - y1 = m × x^2 - x^1. And the last thing to do here is, because point slope form is working with one point and the slope, we don't need these two subscripts. So I'm going to just go ahead and take those off and rewrite this as y - y1 = m × x - x^1. And there you go, we have now found point slope form. So if you ever need the point slope form for a line, there's no need in memorizing it, because you can just take the slope formula and do a little bit of rearranging to get point slope form.
To find the x or y intercept, all you need to do is plug in 0 for the opposite variable.
If you're just working with the equation and you need to find the x and y intercept, it's as easy as plugging in 0 for the opposite variable. And that's because for the x-intercept, my y-coordinate, or the height of the x-axis, is always 0. See how it crosses through 0 here? So I'm going to simply plug in 0 for y and solve for x. And when I do that, I get x = 2. So I simply write 2 in for my x-coordinate, and my y-coordinate is 0 since that's what I plugged in to our equation. Likewise, to find the y-intercept, I'm just going to plug in 0 for x, because the y-axis always crosses the x-axis at 0. And because whenever I plug in 0 for x, I'm just left with the constant that's added or subtracted from the end. That is why in y=mx+b form, b is the y-intercept. So all I have to do here is write the -1 in for y.
Plotting points will not only help you when you're stuck, but it can also help guide you to which variable is the independent and which is the dependent variable.
Of course, if you're ever stuck, you can always plot points. To do this, you make a little x and y table. Choose some values for x. I'm going to choose -1, 0, and 1. And then plug those values into your equation to figure out what the output or y value will be. When I do that, I get the coordinates -1, -5, 0, -2, and 1, 1. Now this will also help you understand which is the independent and dependent variable, because the independent variable is always the variable you choose first when plotting points. So the x variable in this case is the independent, and the value that we got as the output is the dependent variable. Sometimes books will try to trick you by using different letters than x and y in their linear equations. So thinking about how you would plot points is a really good way to help you keep straight which is the independent and dependent variables.
Parallel lines always, always, always have the same slope.
If you're looking at these two lines in y equals mx plus b form, remember that the coefficient on x is the slope. And because these are the same, we know that the lines are parallel. What that means is that these two lines never cross because they're going in the exact same direction. The only difference between the lines is that they cross the y-axis in different places. So if you ever need to construct a parallel line to another, you'll want to make sure that the slope of your new line is the same as the slope of your original line.
Perpendicular lines will always have negative reciprocal slopes.
To make a line that has a perpendicular slope, you simply want to take the negative reciprocal of the slope of the line you have. So for instance, in this equation, my slope equals 3. The negative reciprocal would mean I take this as a fraction, so 3 over 1. I flip it upside down, so I get 1/3. And then I change the sign. So since this was a positive, I'll make this one negative. Now, the slope of any line that's perpendicular to our y equals 3x will have a slope of negative 1/3. If I know the point I want that line to go through, I can easily construct that equation by plugging in negative 1/3 for the slope and the desired point into the point slope formula.
Linear modeling problems pretty much always boil down to the same two pieces of information. You're looking for an initial or start value, as well as a change per unit.
Suppose I have a lemonade stand that costs $15 to build, and each cup of lemonade cost me 25 cents to make, and I sell each cup for $1. Let's write a linear equation to represent the profit of this lemonade stand. So pretty much all linear equation word problems boil down to the same sort of two things. Your y-intercept is now the value that represents the starting or initial value. In this example, that's the negative $15 it cost you to build, and the slope represents the change per unit. So if I'm making a profit equation, I want to know how much money I make per unit or per cup of lemonade. Here it costs me 25 cents to make the lemonade, and I sell each cup for $1. So my profit or my change per unit is 75 cents in the positive. So a linear equation to model profit, I might want to use P for profit instead of Y, and my change is, we said 75 cents, a positive 75 cents per cup of lemonade. Now I can choose to keep X or use a different variable. I'm going to use C for cups. And it cost me $15 to build, so I start out at negative $15 profit. So I'm going to do minus 15 there.
That's it, the top 10 linear equation facts. And I think if you have a good grasp on those 10 concepts, you will be set for any linear equation problems you run across. If you'd like a list of these 10 must-know facts, check out the description box below where I have a PDF linked for you. And while you're there, why don't you hit that big thumbs up button to recommend this video? And if you haven't already, I encourage you to subscribe and join the Math Hacks family. I'm Brett. Until next time, thank you for joining me.